revolutionizing the way people treat people in business. The Experience Pros, America's home for positive business talk.
This is America's home for positive business talk, empowering you to build your brand on the radio. Do you want to have even more media exposure in the coming year? You can download our complimentary report for how to get even more media exposure at massivemediaexposure.com. That's massivemediaexposure.com. Once you're plugged in there, we'll plug you into our Facebook group as well, where we're running our 1,000 fans in 100 days campaign to kickstart your momentum, to put that base of 1,000 customers in play for you as you grow your business. Of course, Ricci-Lee is sitting in with me today. Eric is in San Diego. She's a registered dietitian and a nutritionist. She has her master's in nutrition. She's also a competitive ballroom dancer. And so we've been talking a little bit just about how to be healthier, how to not just go for a fad diet, but to actually change our lifestyle. Ricci-Lee, I've seen some kind of before and after pictures of you. Tell your story of the journey that you made to get healthier.
So for me, I was a gymnast for about 11 years. And so I was constantly active, you know, 5 days a week, 25 hours a week of practice and training. And then I quit. And then all of a sudden, you know, I went to the gym a little bit, but it wasn't the same. And I was eating the same amount of food and I started gaining weight and I didn't know what to do with it. I was 16 and I'm kind of in that awkward stage of my life. And I found ballroom dancing and I started getting into dancing, found an activity I actually enjoyed doing so that being physically active wasn't a pain. It was something I wasn't going to just do for a few weeks and quit.
Right.
And then eating wise, I was also dealing with a lot of different food sensitivities. I couldn't figure out what made me feel sick, but I knew a lot of foods were making me feel sick, which was part of the weight gain for me as well.
Sure.
So for me, you know, I went through a bunch of different testing and really started to just focus on my nutrition and what I needed to do, whether it was portion sizes, timing of meals, things like that, taking the time to even eat my meal a little bit slower so that I took 20 minutes instead of 10 to eat a meal. And I actually felt full and didn't need to go back for seconds.
I think so many of us just scarf it down every now and then. You realize you haven't eaten in so many hours and you look down at your plate and it's empty and you think, where did that go? I just inhaled it.
Yeah. And so that's something I did for many years. And I even on and off did that, you know, through my undergraduate program in nutrition. And my first job out of school, I was working in intensive outpatient eating disorders. And I ran meal support groups 3 nights a week where I had to sit with my clients and we had dinner together. And we had to have our correct portioned meals and we had to take minimum 25 minutes to eat our meal.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Mm-hmm. Now the portions, I've read a lot recently about something like the palm of your hand is the amount of your protein.
Right.
You go out to a restaurant. I don't think they got that memo.
No. So they like to give you the concept of more bang for your buck, which we all say, oh great, we got all this food. What I work with my clients on a lot when it comes to eating out at restaurants is we work on what a portion size looks like. And then we take that next step to say, order a box at the beginning of your meal, not at the end, and take what's on your plate that fits your meal plan or what you know you should be eating and put the rest in the box right off the bat.
We usually you wait until whatever is left over, but you start at the beginning.
Right
at the beginning, this is the portion. We put the rest of it in the box. So it's not even sitting on my plate. Because we kind of grew up, I did, in the
clean your plate.
The area of clean your plate. Yeah. Finish everything on your plate. And so to leave food on the plate or to feel wasteful, I've got to eat all of this, even though I'm full or I'm no longer hungry.
Exactly.
We just keep eating.
So if it's in front of you, you're going to eat it. It's human nature. It's easy to have a conversation and just be picking at the food even after you're full. So if you put it in the box, put it aside right away, you can clean your plate, be satisfied with what you've eaten, and have an extra meal to bring home.
Right. And now I've got lunch for tomorrow or the next day's meal. And there's bang for your buck, right?
Heck yeah.
Right? Okay, this is good. And now what's the benefit of eating slow?
So the benefit of eating slow is essentially your body produces hormones and signals that tell you when you're full. If we take our time to eat, number one, we're actually taking the time to taste and enjoy the food we're putting in our mouths, mm-hmm. so we don't have the craving for more afterwards. And we're giving our body enough time for those hormones to kind of signal our brain that, hey, I actually am full.
Mm. Okay, right? Because but I think if you eat it so fast, you don't even realize it until a few minutes later, probably.
Right. So your body takes at least 20 minutes before it even realizes that you've fed it anything. So it'll say you're still hungry, and then next thing you know, you've had your seconds, and now you're stuffed.
Okay. All right. So what's the craziest diet, fad diet that you've heard of?
I mean, I've heard of a ton of crazy ones these days. Probably the craziest one is the cookie diet.
You mentioned that.
Right.
Is this really eating cookies?
It is. So it was something that they used to advertise on a radio station back in Tucson for years. And they got their one cookie a day or whatever. And then that's what they ate for the whole day. So yeah, you're going to lose weight because you're eating less calories.
But there's no nutrition in that at all.
There's no nutrition. It is not healthy for you in any way, shape, or form. So people were doing whatever they could to see results, and hey, they got to eat cookies. Mm-hmm. But it's not healthy for your body. And a lot of those fad diets take you into this yo-yo dieting concept mm-hmm. where we lose the weight and then we gain it back and we lose it and we gain it back. And that's actually less healthy for you than maintaining a slightly higher weight.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Well, you want to talk to somebody who's gone to school, who is licensed, who has a master's in nutrition. She specializes in nutrition counseling. She actually has a report, a free report that you can download on why fad diets work for some, but not for others. The website is faddietsecrets.com, faddietsecrets.com. Just listening to some of this is, you would think would be common sense, but it's not at all mm-hmm. how restaurants serve us or what we've been taught as children. Mm-hmm. And so I can see that when it comes to nutrition, why it's so confusing.
Right. And it's important to find a trustworthy, reputable expert to go and work with, especially if you're exploring something outside of general healthy eating, because you never know what you're going to get, and there's so much false information out there.
There is. We'll get the best information from Ricci-Lee Hotz. Check out her report, faddietsecrets.com. So excited to have you here today. Share. Go and follow us on Facebook, where you can catch the video at the Facebook Live of our Experience Pros radio show every single day. Never miss an episode. Plus, check out the 800-plus podcasts we've just downloaded or uploaded to YouTube.
The Experience Pros, revolutionizing the way people treat people in business.